Finally, my first shiny Magikarp. So happy, so happy. Off of a raid too. But so, so happy about that. Ain't she nice? Hello YouTube world, this is Swan DLS coming to you with a brand new video. Now for this video, I'm gonna give you a few tips on how to defeat Mewtwo. Now as you know, that Mewtwo is coming soon. We don't know when, but very, very soon. He's coming off with exclusive raids, and you're gonna have to actually get an invite to actually get into this raid. And here's how the invite works. You have to have already defeated a raid boss within the past few weeks at a particular gym. Then that gym's gonna send you an invitation to the Mewtwo raid from there, which is gonna give you plenty of time to, of course, gather your friends, find other people who've also got invited, and then from there you go ahead and take on the Mewtwo. But the thing is that Mewtwo is a power hitter. He's a huge, huge power hitter. And plus, you're gonna have to hope that enough good and strong trainers come out and are also invited to that gym to help you out with that. So I'm gonna go ahead and give you a few details about some of the basic ideas that are going around the internet and some ideas of my own that I thought might help out as well. But first, let's go ahead and check out what Mewtwo has available to him. Okay, so I looked up the spreadsheet for Mewtwo. So his fast attacks are both Confusion and Psycho Cut, which are both psychic moves, so that's easy enough to deal with. But it's his charge moves that you really have to be careful about, because not only is he going to have, of course, psychic, but he has the potential of having Shadow Ball, Hyper Beam, and Focus Blast. And if you go ahead in there with a team of just one type of Pokemon, you could find yourself in a little bit of a pickle there. So I'm gonna go ahead and give a lot of different variations of Pokemon that can kind of help alleviate and ease yourself off of that little worry, all right? All right, well, let's go ahead and start off with the crowd favorite. Let's face it, Tyranitar is definitely top of the list, as of always. Now, against Mewtwo, though, you want that Bite and Crunch, which I know a lot of you had already switched out Crunch for Stone Edge for the birds, but you want Bite and Crunch for Mewtwo, because that dark type that he has is going to strongly resist psychic attacks, and that bite attack and that crunch attack is going to be super effective against Mewtwo. But this is definitely a crowd favorite, definitely a huge power hitter to have in your arsenal. Now, one of my all-time personal favorite Pokemon of all time, Houndoom. That's right, Houndoom is actually going to be a very, very good weapon to go up against Mewtwo. Now, also, like Tyranitar, it's a dark type, so he's going to go ahead and resist that psychic attack. And with Snarl and Foul Play, definitely a good combo to go up against that, because you're dealing with double dark moves, which, of course, is going to deal a lot of damage to the psychic type Mewtwo. Now, I also suggest a Gyarados with Bite and Crunch. Now hear me out on this. Keep this in mind that Mewtwo is going to have an array of different attacks. So if you're using just all dark types, let's say if your Mewtwo happens to have Focus Blast, then you're in a rough spot. But Gyarados, as a flying and water type, actually can resist fighting type moves. And with Bite and Crunch, it's going to deal a lot of damage to Mewtwo. So just in case, this is going to be a good one to have on your side, that way you have some variety in your team. Alright, another good Pokemon to have on your side, especially going against Mewtwo, is Scizor. Now, with the moves Fury Cutter and X Scizor, this is actually going to be a great weapon to have on your side against Mewtwo. The big thing with Scizor as well is that it only has one weakness, and that's fire. And Mewtwo can do no fire attacks, so you're definitely good to have him on your side, and he's going to go ahead and take normal damage. So he'll definitely be a good choice to have on your side to go up against Mewtwo. Alright, so this next Pokemon is basically in everybody's list of tools to use. And that's right, it's Dragonite. With his moveset and its high stats, it's going to be the top choice for basically anything, including Mewtwo. Now, one thing about this, though, that you have to take note on is that Dragonite can resist Focus Blast. So if you end up with a Mewtwo with Focus Blast, this is actually going to be a big help for you, because it has some resistance to it, and Dragonite can do a lot of damage. So this will be definitely a good choice for you to have in the back of your mind, you know, just in case. All right, now this next one, I personally never thought that this Pokemon will become useful to me at all, but apparently now it's gonna be a hot commodity. That's right, Pinsir with this moveset Bug Bite and X Scissors is going to be a great, great weapon to go up against Mewtwo because, well, it's a bug type. And psychic types are weak against bug attacks. So if you have one of these, and they're actually fairly easy to get. These things, they're everywhere. So if you have a good Pinsir, this will definitely help you out against the raids against Mewtwo. Alright, now, these next few Pokemon that I'm about to list off, they're not the top choice, but hear me out on this, because just like we talked about before, Mewtwo has a lot of different power attacks, and if you go with some of the more popular choices right from the bat, you could end up in a tight spot. So, kind of consider some of these Pokemon as we go through along with the rest of this video. Okay, so next off is Umbreon. Now, the reason why he wasn't in the list on the top Pokemon to choose is because, well, Umbreon's attack is meh. Even as a dark type Pokemon, his attacks don't go that far, but he is a dark type Pokemon, so let's just keep that in mind. And he can resist psychic attacks. Now, as far as anybody low level, these are actually probably the easiest Pokemon to get as well. So if you're kind of like in that lower half of the level and you want to contribute, definitely pick this Pokemon. He'll definitely help you out with that. Now, this next Pokemon is, well, we're fighting Legendary with a Legendary. Lugia is actually going to be a fairly interesting choice to go up against Mewtwo, but with a particular moveset. Now, Mewtwo, if he has his psychic attacks or if he has Focus Blast, Lugia is going to be able to resist that fairly decently. And it's Legendary, so it has quite a bit of defense on him. But if you have the move Dragon Tail and Sky Attack, Mewtwo won't be able to get as much damage on Lugia, but Lugia will be able to get normal damage on Mewtwo. And if it has Sky Attack, he's going to benefit from the stab bonus, as Lugia is also a flying type. So if you have a Lugia, if you manage to catch a Lugia, and trust me, you have time to still catch Lugia, Lugia will not go away until the 31st of this month, definitely use Lugia. He'll definitely help you out with that. Okay, I know this looks like an odd choice, but hear me out. Exeggutor can actually resist a lot of Mewtwo's attacks. I mean, he's a grass and psychic type, which means psychic moves aren't gonna be that effective on him. Neither are fighting moves either, so you don't have to worry about Focus Blast too much. And with the move Solar Beam, Exeggutor can hit hard. And plus, I mean, executes are fairly common, so most people should have an Exeggutor at this point, unless they've basically just started the game and they're still working on it. But Exeggutor is going to be a fairly decent choice to go up against Mewtwo. All I know is I have 100%, so I'm definitely going to try this out. Now, another odd choice that I like to go ahead and point out is Alakazam. Now, here's the deal. Again, you're dealing with another psychic attack Pokemon against psychic attack Pokemon, so psychic attacks aren't going to do well with each other, but Alakazam can learn Shadow Ball. And Shadow Ball is super effective against psychic types. And so if you have Alakazam and you're going up against Mewtwo that has both psychic moves, then you know that your Shadow Ball is going to deal some heavy damage. And Alakazam can actually resist some psychic moves. He doesn't have a lot of defense on him, but this is going to be another good choice to have, you know, just in case. Alright, and for the final Pokemon of this list, we have Gengar. Now, here's the deal with Gengar. He can either be an absolute powerhouse or an absolute glass cannon. Because here's the deal, depending on Mewtwo's power move, so if he has Hyper Beam or Focus Blast, Gengar is going to be able to resist that, and with his fast attack of Shadow Claw, which can cause a lot of damage per second, and Shadow Ball, which are two ghost type moves, this will be an excellent choice to go up against Mewtwo. But here's the deal. With its poison typing, if Mewtwo has Confusion, or with his ghost typing, he has Shadow Ball as well, Gengar is going down and going down hard. So you gotta really be careful as far as choosing this Pokemon. So you have to kinda know what Mewtwo has before you go ahead and choose this one. But he will be a great weapon to have with you against Mewtwo. Alright, now I have one more bit of advice for some of you who have done this, and let me give you this scenario out. I've powered up and I've used up charge TMs for this one Pokemon to take on the birds, and now you're telling me, oh my goodness, I have to go ahead and change it up again. Let's say if you have a Tyranitar and you've worked hard to one, get a Tyranitar, power up a Tyranitar, make sure that it has Bite and Stone Edge instead of Bite and Crunch, and now people are telling you, hey, get rid of Mewtwo, and oh yeah, by the way, Bite and Crunch, you're probably thinking to yourself, really? I just used up Charge TM just to get the other move, now you're telling me to change it back. Well, I do have one suggestion to actually help alleviate that a little bit. All right, my suggestion is this: have multiple Pokemon of the same type. Now, here's what I ended up doing. I have my one Tyranitar with Bite and Stone Edge, and this Tyranitar is going to be solely for the birds, or just for powerhouse attacking. Now, I do have another Tyranitar here with Bite and Crunch. This one, its sole purpose is for Mewtwo. But I suggest doing this, that way you have an array of different Pokemon for different situations, and you can go ahead and label them. Like, I named one of mine Mary just because a friend of mine said go ahead and do it, and once I get around to it, I'm gonna name this other Tyranitar something different. That way I know in my head that, hey look, I'm going to get to Mewtwo, let me use this Tyranitar instead of that Tyranitar. But this is one suggestion that I have that I think people should really take advantage of and really hop on top of. That way you're prepared for all situations, not having to go out your way for different types of situations. All right, one more little bit of advice, and this is kind of just a side noter for those of you who are out raiding, trying to make sure that you get your invite for that Mewtwo, and it is this. Raids are now giving out potions for prizes. That's right, they finally changed that up, and we are getting potions for raids instead of just getting a bunch of revives and not being able to heal our Pokemon. So, like today, earlier, as I caught my Magikarp, I actually got a regular potion. I also went up against the Muk and got a super potion, so I believe the level of the raid dictates what kind of potion that you could get. It's not a guaranteed thing, you could get a potion, but that should definitely help out some of you who are definitely struggling for potions and struggling to heal up your Pokemon, especially after going up against an array of different raids. Alright, that's all the tips that I have for you today. Now, if you enjoyed this video, definitely fire up a like, and do not forget to hit that subscribe button. The more support that I get for the channel, the more that drives up more videos and helps this channel grow. But until the next time, folks, later.